We'll now have a brief run-through of the color correction tools in Autodesk Smoke. Firstly, you have two color correction tools to choose from. We'll start off with the color corrector. Select this segment in the sequence and apply the color correct timeline effects. Like all the other timeline effects, you can do quick adjustments in the basic parameters bar. If you enter the editor, you will be presented with a plethora of controls. Now, before we look at any detail, the color correct timeline effects has two ways to display the interface. Pressing Ctrl Escape toggles the interface between the standard mode and the overlay mode. The overlay interface allows you to see your image full screen. As you adjust a particular value, the other controls are temporarily hidden. To get to the standard interface, press Ctrl Escape. Now, all the tools in the color correct timeline effects are capable of grading and look development. So here you can adjust masters, shadows, midtones, and highlights. There is also a color wheel for tinting, numeric adjustments, a histogram, and curves. These tools should all be familiar to you if you've worked in software of a similar nature. You can play with these tools to get used to them, but we'll exit the editor and move on to the next color correction tool. Hold Option and click on the color correct timeline effects to delete it off the segment. The second color correction tool in Smoke is called the Color Warper. To apply the Color Warper timeline effects, select the segment and click the Effects button. In the Effects ribbon, click the Color Warper timeline effects. Similar to the color correct timeline effects, the Basics parameters bar will give you quick access to the basic controls. Let's step into the editor and have a look at the Color Warper controls. Just like the color correct timeline effects, pressing Ctrl Escape toggles between the standard and overlay interface. One feature unique to the Color Warper is the interactive vectorscope. This allows you to sample colors for balancing and warping. These tasks are covered in another video. Focusing on the main interface, the Color Warper uses a series of trackballs to manipulate the color of an image. You can also set the black and white levels of an image. And you can also do selective color correction with the Color Warper, which will be covered in the next video. Press the Exit button to return to the sequence. Now you can add a color correct timeline effects as well as a Color Warper timeline effects to the segment at the same time. So as an example, you could use one tool to balance the image and the other to develop the final look. There is no right way or wrong way to use these tools. Just use what best suits the job. Just be aware that the sequence is capable of working up to 16-bit float point. All the tools, including the color correction tools, support the various bit depths. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.